say $782.
Yeah!
It took five sets tonight in Iowa City, and Northwestern rejoices with a huge road win over the Hawkeyes. Let's get you the top three plays. Nia Robinson set a new career high with 26 kills.
Oh, she was amazing, hitting those sharp angles all night long. Big time clutch player.
Northwestern brought the energy all evening long. You can look to the bench getting it going.
Yeah, I can't do those dance moves. I'm sure you can't either, Mike. But they brought the energy, and that's what you need on a road match. Northwestern having a lot of fun on the sidelines.
Wildcats jumped their way to a huge win, but the number one play tonight, someone not playing on the court. After this serve from Olivia Viscuso, check out the cheer team.
Well, he knows how to make those great catches, and maybe Iowa needed him more involved in this match. Great effort by the cheerleader.
With hands like Noah Fant, Iowa and Northwestern battled it out, but the Wildcats get the win. Star Taylor Lewis leads Iowa at Carver Hawkeye Arena as the Hawkeyes clash with Nia Robinson and the Northwestern Wildcats in a key Big Ten match. Our doubleheader on BTN continues from Iowa City. This is Big Ten Volleyball, powered by American Ethanol. Thanks so much for joining us alongside former Wisconsin great Liz Tortorella Nelson, Mike Monaco here with you. We're ready to start the second half of the Big Ten season, and both these coaches think that their teams are well positioned for an improvement in the second half of the season.
Well, definitely. Iowa really likes their identity right now, and Northwestern is healthy, and they finally know what lineup they're going to go with. Both teams want to go forward and not look backward at their schedule. They're so excited about these next 10 matches coming along.
We're going to zero in on the starting opposites on both sides in this matchup. For Iowa, Reagan Coyle is a senior, a former walk-on. She was outstanding in the first meeting between these teams.
Well, she's a senior, she's a right side, and a captain. She knows how to block, that's for sure. 9 blocks last time against Northwestern. She's a veteran out there, has been in some really big matches. Bree Orr likes to reverse the ball to her, and she got 18 kills last time.
And for Northwestern, Aubriana Canna is a freshman. She is someone with a huge ceiling on this team, and she does whatever Northwestern wants her.
She sure does, and what a great freshman that is. She's so athletic. She's got a big block, that she's a natural blocker. Such a high ceiling as an athletic body out there. But she can get it done in the front row. Touches 10-4, and she's worked both sides of the pin, and she's even a passer right now.
Both teams feel ready to take that next step in the second half of the Big Ten season. The Wildcats and the Hawkeyes just about set to get started. Here for Carver Hawkeye Arena. Starting lineups and first serve coming right up after this. Northwestern on the road. This is the Iowa Hawkeyes as we begin the second half officially of the Big Ten season. Alongside former Wisconsin great Liz Tortorella Nelson and Mike Monaco on hand. Second matchup, Liz, between these two. They met at the end of September. They went 5 sets.
A marathon match. We have Nia Robinson hitting an all-time high, 25 kills. And Aubriana Cannon, not only she can add those blocks in there, but she got 13 kills as well. But I love the Iowa side, 23 blocks on the night.
Both these teams feel like they have the ability to take some steps forward in the second portion of the season. Northwestern's coming off its first Big Ten win of the season over the weekend on Friday against Michigan State. There is so much youth. There's not a single senior on the Wildcats roster.
Well, it's hard to imagine that. I mean, they play at such a high level, and they finally have a great lineup set. They're healthy, and they're ready to attack this next second half of the Big Ten.
For Iowa, meanwhile, they have a couple big outside hitters in veterans. Taylor Lewis, Callie Hoy, they have drawn so much attention around the conference, but Von Schmanski is focused in the middle. They have so many freshmen there.
Well, they need to pump the middle as much as they can tonight. They're not getting enough production out of them. The outside hitters are doing their part. Multiple kills, double-digit kills every single night. It's the middle production that they're looking at.
So those are the starting lineups powered by American Ethanol as we are getting ready for this one. Shane Davis is in his third year at Western, and he's only 90 minutes away right now from where he grew up. an Iowa kid. He grew up in Denver, Iowa, a one-stoplight town, and you're familiar there. You recruited his sister as well.
I sure did. I remember going back to Denver, Iowa, and visiting Sherry Davis, who's on the bench. He actually was playing basketball at that time, if you can imagine.
Bob Schumanski grew up in Iowa as well, right here in Iowa City. He's now in his fifth season as the head coach, an Iowa graduate, and he is taking this program to new heights. They've had some marquee wins this season.
Yeah, fifth season overall for Bond. I think he feels very comfortable with the team culture right now. They're gritty, they're competitive, and he's got a great group right here ready to compete at the next level.
Well, we have some of the best outside hitters in the conference in this matchup. We mentioned the name of Taylor Lewis. She boasts nearly 4 kills per set, and so too does Nia Robinson, sophomore L1 for Northwestern.
Just looking at this heavy-duty lineup out here, and such fantastic pin hitters. You got Erica Pritchard, too. Just an amazing set of athletes out there representing the Big Ten.
Yeah, Jacqueline Quaid, Carly Scott on some top 20 teams in this conference as well. So the second half of the Big Ten season ready to get underway tonight. As we continue our doubleheader on BTN, many of you might have seen Northwestern, or rather Nebraska, go into Columbus and get the win over Ohio State. Wildcats on the road in their purple. Molly Kelly is the libero for Iowa. On the fly to Alana Walker, a very athletic middle, sophomore out of Chicago.
Do you like to see her get numbers on the board right away, establishing the middle? And that's what Shane Davis told us. He wanted to get some action behind the setter, get to that right side pin, and start scoring.
Michelle Lee is the freshman libero for Northwestern out of Naperville, Illinois. Rick Bomber's the setter. She goes to the back set. Kept up. And the call goes against Iowa. So Northwestern out of the gates up 2-0.
Really keep an eye on their serving tonight, Mike. They both have quality. Lee being one of them.
You talk to coaches around the conference, they say the same thing. Northwestern just rips its serving. In the words of Kelly Sheffield, Wisconsin's head coach, they get the bejesus out of it. And the Hawkeyes are on the board. Reagan Coyle, the senior from Council Bluffs, Iowa, just outside of Omaha.
One of many kills, I'm sure, for the evening. I love how she's patient. Bree Orr really had to deliver the ball all the way across the net, and Reagan Coyle keeps the ball in front of her and finds the kill.
There's Nia Robinson. First kill for the sophomore from Indianapolis, who we showed you is fourth in the conference in kills per set.
5 kills last time. They competed against each other. She knows what she needs to do. She's scoring a lot of points for this team, carrying a heavy load.
Yeah, heavy load because Northwestern, of course, this year without the services of Simone Abbott, who was so good in her Wildcats career.
Needs to find an answer for somebody like a Coyle. She's going to get her kills, but what you want to do is make sure you get your hand on that ball and somehow slow down the pace of the ball.
Schumanski was hoping for more, and just the outside hitters on the left side getting a ball. On the middle, running some more from Coyle. Four. Went to the left side. She set up Callie Boyd.
It's off the antenna. She's really good with a high hand, tool the block, something she's familiar with. She loves tooling the block on that left side pin. One of the things that she needs to work on, Coach had said, is more of a range hitter. She needs to work on that wrist away shot.
There's Allie Lindroth, junior from Plainfield, Illinois. DS for Northwestern, which has the block going early on in set one.
Cannon up there. Nice eye sequence, really moving well together. Cannon gets her hands up and over fast and delivers the block.
Good start for for Northwestern, 11-11 overall on the season and 1-9 in the Big Ten, coming off the win on Friday and three sets over Michigan State. Four on the back set, another Wildcats block. Viscuso side by side with Ella Gerback, the freshman.
We don't identify that the coil is getting the ball. Good release by Viscuso to get over there to close the block.
Efficient start for the Wildcats, who are on a 3-0 run now. Or goes right back to Coyle and gets it through the block this time.
Sometimes you just have to hit that ball really hard to get it through the block, and that's something that she knows how to do. She's a senior. She's been in big-time matches. She's seen a lot of volleyball.
Yeah,
and that's one of the things you learn. You do have to test the integrity of the block, and she just did that.
That's a crazy year for Kane Davis, quite a bit. Point goes to Wildcats on the service there. There's Olivia Viscuso, junior middle from Arlington, Texas, the M2. A walk-on for the Wildcats. Kept up, nearly an ace serve. Bomber. Set the right side, and there's Aubriana Cannon. They've moved her all over the floor in her freshman season. She's out of Novi, Michigan.
Oh, I love the fact that she's got such a fast tempo set out there, and she's taking her first step to the ball as soon as the setter is releasing it. So it's not a high ball on the right side pin. It's almost a shoe set going behind.
A serve from Viscuso. A 6-1 run for the Wildcats.
This is a huge part of their game, the serve and pass game right now for Northwestern. One of the key points in order to beat a team like Iowa, they have to make sure that they're putting pressure on that Iowa serve receive.
Junior outside hitter, also in the top 10 in the Big Ten in kills per set. Bomber sets the middle. A swing from Alana Walker. Bomber goes back to Cannon, and it's a 6-point cushion for Northwestern.
Well, Taylor Lewis is up there waiting, but goes up a little too early, and Cannon takes advantage. Here you see just a wind-up by Lewis, but her arms are still flailing. She's not stopped in motion. Her arms are still moving. So that's a big target out there, Mike, for somebody to tool off of.
Hitting error from Iowa. So Northwestern up by 7, and they've had kills from 4 different people. What do you like about the way the Brick Bomber is spreading it around?
Well, she's doing a nice job, and here's a setter that didn't have a lot of opportunity to play a 5-1 in the beginning of the season. She was playing a 6-2, so a 5-1 is fairly new for her, and she's doing a nice job. She's not as offensive as I'd like to see her right now, but she's focused on setting a good ball and distributing it well.
She goes to the back set this time for Alana Walker.
And
her second kill.
Going against the grain, too, reversing the low to somebody like Alana Walker, who Alana's going to get up there. She's athletic. She's going to show her arm. She's going to find a way to get a touch on that ball. But Britt is the one that delivers it. Puts it right into her sweet spot.
Four. That's with Maya Jones on the slot. Point to the Hawkeyes.
Of course, we just talk about her being offensive and with the net call, and that's okay. She's trying to establish herself as a hitter. And setters need to have a high hitting percentage if they're up there and they're going to attack.
In middle, Jones, sir. Or for a back row attack from Kelly Boyd.
We're going to find her no matter where she is on the court. That is a very fast tempo. A big play, a very fast back row attack, something that the men's game started a long time ago and brought over to the women's game, where they really use it as a first tempo option. A lot of teams use it in system. as a back row attack, not
option. Yeah, not just as a bailout option. Or since Taylor Lewis kept up off the net. Or right back to Lewis. Net call on the Wildcats.
A good scrappy defense on both sides of the net just to keep that rally going. Northwestern does a nice job of keeping it in play. Unfortunately, an unforced error at the net. But Taylor Lewis is up there. She got a couple tight sets, and she was still able to do something with that ball.
There's the pick again to Callie Horn. Sure back. Line shot from the freshman.
I gotta mix it up. I like Allie Lindros back there, digging the ball, doing a nice job. Somebody, again, that did not show up in the beginning of the season. She was injured, just came alive the last couple of matches, but scrapping her way, keeping the ball up so they can work on that transition game.
And Gerbeck now part of his balance offensively from the Wildcats up by six. Bonner on a back set to Walker. Good coverage from the libero Lee. Swing is long. And Mia Robinson.
One thing Coach Davis did talk to us, Mike, about was managing the air. And it's something he's very conscious of, especially with this young group. It's hard to do that. They're going to be aggressive. They're going to take some big swings out there. But you cannot do it where you end up getting into runs. They've got to make sure they keep the score where it is. They have the advantage. If you add a couple of airs in there, you lose it fast. But Bird Bomber gives a nice out-of-system ball. Unfortunately, a little too tight. And Iowa took advantage of it.
Good top serve from Iowa. Or the outside. Reagan Coyle.
Reagan Coyle does it again. She takes that big back swing, really approaches to the ball. You see that cross body shot.
Arizona 3-0 scoring. At home within three.
Down here, she takes big swings from the outside pins, cross body shot, but also on the right side, she finds a way to put the ball down. 5 kills so far on the evening.
And she had 18 in the first meeting between these teams at the end of September, hit above 400 in that 5-7 in Iowa.
Well, she's gritty, she's tough, the coach really likes to talk about her, and they need her right now. They need her, that kill production out of Reagan Coyle.
Well, you said earlier she's got the power to hit through the block. Von Szymanski said she's not going to jump over you, but she can break fingers with her swing. Taylor Lewis can as well, but she had an attack error. So Northwestern's up by 5, just past the midway point in set 1. But these teams feel like they have some momentum headed toward the second half of the Big Ten season, with the schedules perhaps a bit more favorable down the stretch. It's tipped in from Coyle, and the point to Iowa on the double contact from the Wildcats.
Another error by Northwestern, and I was ready to capitalize. They were so excited to be home right now. Been on the road for a few matches, and they've really appreciated the fact that, you know, the Iowa fans came out big and hard against Purdue, over 4,000. A lot of those new fans are learning volleyball. You see Mia Robinson going up hard line. Where you are is right there. Good thing she put her hands up to protect her face.
Saw some big swings earlier tonight on DTN from Vanya Bukele, the 6'6" freshman on Ohio State, teeing off her share of the time against Nebraska. Good block from Northwestern early on. They're up by 6.
Nice to take them out of system.
Timeout, Von Szymanski. It's a 6-point deficit for the Hawkeyes at home. Powered by high-octane, clean-burning American ethanol. The power behind E15. There's a costume contest tonight inside Carver Hawkeye Arena. Halloween a week early. So Liz Tortorella Nelson, what are you going to be for Halloween?
Well, I am going to be none other than a volleyball coach. Of course, anything will be sectional here.
always busy around the Midwest at this time of year. We're into the second half of the Big Ten schedule. Good one so far here in Iowa City. On the overpass, that is out. Ripped right at Britt Bomber, and Callie Hoy racks up her third kill.
Well, just trying to adjust on somebody like Callie Hoy. You saw there, they didn't give her as much line, but you have a defender down the line ready to go.
Molly Kelly serves. Bomber set the middle to Olivia Viscuso.
Great attack by Olivia up there. Being efficient, really important for her to find a way to get up and score, especially against a one-on-one opportunity. Amaya Jones not able to move to her right side, so open gate for Olivia Viscuso to get that kill.
It's a really good sign for Shane Davis. She struggled a little bit over the weekend in a couple matches against the Spartans and Wolverines. Callie Hoy starting to get going up to four kills.
She really got going against Wisconsin a few weeks ago. 30 kills for that young lady. On the left side, Wisconsin did not have an answer for those outside hitters, Taylor Lewis and Callie Hood.
That was that program-changing type of win the Hawkeyes had here at Carver Hawkeye 2.5 weeks ago. Bomber on the back set to Cannon. Kelly ran out of room.
This might have a way to get a tool, which is great for Cannon up there. She's doing a nice job. She's looking for hands, and that's what you need to do. The block can be your friend, Mike, for sure. It doesn't always have to be darkness or your enemy. You want to make sure you're finding those elbows or those moving hands up there and take advantage of it.
And that's a mature approach for a freshman starting on the right side.
It sure is, and you've got to be aggressive, and you've got to be confident up there to go for those tool shots.
Callie Hoy, cross court for the kill.
Nice cross court angle, something different for her, Callie Hoy. She's been working on that range game. Big back swing, and she really gives it away early, too. She's forcing her left shoulder in, a little bit of a hip rotation. The defense on Northwestern will need to adjust after that one.
5 kills on 10 swings for Hoy. Northwestern by 5 and a kill for Gerbeck.
Gerbeck done a nice job this whole year coming in and making a difference. Not as dynamic as an outside hitter as somebody like Nia Robinson, but plays her role well.
She was originally supposed to redshirt as well for the Wildcats. Had a lot of injuries early on, did this Northwestern team, but finally they're healthy. Roy tried to set out of the back, but it's double contact called on her.
Just watching Iowa's side. They're out of system quite often. Northwestern's getting fits with their serve. But just being able to keep the ball alive and make a play against Northwestern, that's going to be really important for Iowa down the stretch.
Sarah Johnson, junior from Pasadena, California. Rainford is an offensive setter. She goes to the dump.
Well, finally, it's good to see a setter take advantage. And that was a great pass, too. She comes up really strong with that left hand, drops her right shoulder, and goes behind. Tough ball for the defensive side for Northwestern. In the front row, as a blocker for Northwestern, you got to keep an eye on her.
Behind the head a little bit, too. I like that for
a sophomore
out of Eagan, Minnesota. 3 ball from Taylor Lewis. Bomber sets up Walker for the kill.
Really good off the 1 foot. Great dig transition. Alana Walker's taking advantage. She's got those swinging arms. And really lifts her body up. No bra jumping, pike straight up. And finds the block for a two.
3 kills for Walker, who the second time Northwestern played Minnesota, she had 10 kills. Hit 450. And she gets another kill. Northwestern up by 8.
Just a matter of being physical at the net, and this is something that Northwestern can do.
So a timeout by Von Schimanski. Northwestern looking good in set one. Northwestern picked up its first Big Ten win of the season, taking down Michigan State in 3 sets.
Oh, that was huge. And Michigan State, despite their youth, that was a great win. Good signature win for Northwestern. First one on the book, Shane Davis' 300th win for his career.
great stint that he had coaching the men's side at a school you know well in Loyola in Chicago, and now in his third year leading this young Wildcats program. But there's a lot to be excited about if you're Shane Davis and his staff.
Well, think about the difference of switching from a men's program to a women's program. And some people maybe thought it was really easy. I didn't think it was easy at all. I'm sure Shane's thinking the same way. A lot of different aspects of the women's game, just the volume of teams is huge. Over 330 Division I programs for the women's game, less than 50 in the men's.
And Davis now back in his home state, nearly in a serve on set point for Northwestern. Off the net, there it is. Britt Bomber cements set one.
Well, you'll take a kill any way you can get it, right, Mike?
You know that well as a former center.
Always smiles when you get a chance to attack, especially for a kill.
So Northwestern ends set one on a 6-1 run. The Wildcats building up that weekend win. Take the first set in Iowa City. Success tonight centers around some of the best performances among Big Ten players this season. Callie Hoy had those 30 kills in the win over Wisconsin. Nia Robinson at 25, the first meeting between these two.
Huge for those two, but I'm also looking at Carly Scott and Jacqueline Quaid doing a great job for those two programs. Michigan and Illinois battling out. They just had a five-setter recently where Illinois was able to squeeze out of that one at home.
Catch Michigan, Illinois, they're both in action on BTN later on this weekend. We've got a good one here between Iowa and Northwestern. Hoy, Robinson, and company as we head to set two in Iowa City. Liz Tortorello, Nelson, Mike Monaco, our entire BTN crew. For the start of the second half of the conference season. Once again, it's Hannah Lesiak who begins the set serving for Northwestern. Killed right away, right on cue from Callie Hoy.
Well, that's what it takes. It takes a good pass, getting a great set out to the pin, and finding your go-to hitter.
Well, and it's big to have Callie Hoy back. She didn't even travel with Iowa over the weekend due to sickness. A couple players, and Hoy was one of them. So Iowa in some big matches over the weekend didn't have her services against Minnesota and Wisconsin.
Yeah, she was, you know, she's been real impressive for the season. Can you imagine getting that call saying, you know, one of your top outfielders is not ready to go? And I'm sure it was a disappointment to not have her there, but you definitely want her healthy for the rest of the season.
And you know that she's the type of player, too, itching to go. She brings some swagger to this team. Admits herself that she likes to talk a little trash on the court. Perhaps does after her second kill of set two.
Well, let's just watch that again. Got a three-point pass. She's down the line. Northwestern's trying to take her out of the equation, but doesn't help at all. She still goes for that hard tool, aiming downward on Vespuso.
The match high, 7 kills now and hitting above 400. Bomber on the back set. Up nicely by Maddie Slagle, the freshman. And a kill for Northwestern.
That fast set out to Nia Robinson, where Iowa really struggled in the first couple sets against Northwestern last time. They couldn't get behind the rhythm, their tempo when they're blocking. That set's a little bit inside. And so Nia Robinson has that seam shot or a tool shot available for her if she's on target.
Moore couldn't get it over. And so Northwestern serving tough back in front here in set two.
Well, these are great serving opportunities. You got Britt Bomber right now, who's doing such a great job. She can serve well over 7 or 8 aces in the last couple sets and really has a low air percentage for serving.
And then look at the Wildcats right again, forcing Iowa well out of system.
This is what they can do, and this was the game plan going in tonight, was serve and pass, and they wanted to make sure they were working really hard to stop somebody like a coil and manage their errors.
Well, Kelly took the first contact. Cross-court shot just out from Callie Hoy.
Wait, that was around the 3-foot line, I believe.
That's a sharp angle.
That is a very sharp angle. And I love watching that high point of contact. You see right there, she's got that fast wrist stamp. And something a lot of outside hitters develop at a young age, and some it take a long time to do.
Get Iowa out of system, but they convert this time as Hoy tools the block.
Bree seems to be the only one swinging up there. For Bree, or trying to get the middle to produce, you're going to need to start passing a little bit better.
It's been all Hoy in set two so far. Pump set from Britt Bomber. Neil Robinson, a powerful swing.
Oh, big court to hit into. Watching Iowa's defense, they're spread out. It almost looks like they're standing straight up. You cannot do that against Ania Robinson. You've got to make sure you're low and positioning yourself outside the block, ready to take a step on any angle.
And you just said it. It took some time for Iowa to adjust to her in the first meeting between these two. She missed some time at the start of the Big Ten season with a hamstring issue. Von Schimanski and his group didn't know if she would play. She came on and made a huge impact. Hawkeyes within two.
Some great defensive effort from Michelle Lee on the Northwestern side, but Iowa really pushing and needing these points to get back into the set.
Now Maya Jones behind the line to serve, freshman from Indianapolis. Played well on Sunday against Wisconsin. Hawkeyes within one.
Ready and waiting. Bree Orr right there. Really taking a nice shade step over to the outside pin and really pressing into the court. Nice textbook blocking by Bree Orr.
It's Iowa's first block of the night. Northwestern quickly finds an answer with Aubriana Cannon.
She did a nice job in that first set, delivering a bunch of kills. A bunch of tool shots over in the right side pin. She has some good passing to back it up.
Miscuso. Ace serve, the fourth for Northwestern without an error serving.
When you feel it back there on that serving line. You gain a little bit more confidence. Every time you go back there, you watch that ball just drop, and it was positioned perfectly between the two receivers.
So many of these top serves have come from Olivia Miscuso.
Mike, I've watched their practices before for Northwestern, and what you do is you set up a huge block or a huge platform in the areas where you want to serve into, and you just really kind of either aim for them or aim around them. And visually, it's such a great tool for these servers to have. And you can tell, well, besides that one, you can tell that they're really practicing placing this ball where it needs to go.
Sort of serving the gaps, right?
Serving the gap, and but really going after it. You want to serve it low, high point of contact when you reach, so that ball drops fast.
That time the service error, the first one tonight for Northwestern. Back set to Cannon. Balotelli sets Hoy out of the back row just wide. Well, when we talk about this Northwestern serving, there's a difference between serving tough and what Shane Davis said to us. We want to hit home runs with how hard we serve teams.
A lot of practice. I've noticed a big difference in the Big Ten this year with the serving. And how important over the last couple of years, how important the serve has become to everyone talking about. You get a team like Minnesota, where they're number one in the Big Ten, undefeated, very low error. They're not going to take as many risks as a team that like maybe Illinois, who goes out there and going to the road, or Northwestern.
Heck of a shot to the corner from Alana Walker. Five kills on nine swings for Alana Walker.
I love Northwestern hitting percentage right now. I don't believe they've ever hit that high in a set in the Big Ten right now.
They hit above 400 in set one for Shane Davis. It's their first win of a set on the road in more than a month. Four. She's fired up.
She is fired up, and I love her pointing at her teammates saying, let's go, give me a great pass. And look at that wrist away shot, perfect set and tempo all the way out to the pin. It really caught Northwestern's transition game slow.
more able to defend.
Back set to Walker once again. A lot of Walker with six kills now.
She's really feeling it tonight. She's got a good, smooth, fluid approach right here, really reaching high, catching the blockers off guard.
One of the most competitive players that Shane Davis has ever coached.
And you know, the out of system ball as well, and Bree Orr delivers, making sure the ball is in front of her left side hitter. Hoy does a nice job of being patient and then explodes. You want to start off really waiting for that ball, and you want to pick up the speed with your spike approach as you go in.
Block this time, after the serve force Northwestern out of system.
Is really driving this right now. The intensity, it's out of system play. Mia Robinson comes in hard, but too far inside where she's trying to do the crossbody shot.
Smart set, they go right back to her.
And she's only a sophomore too, and she kind of acts like that veteran out there because they don't have a senior out there to lead this team.
Her and Alana Walker, the sophomores, they are the leaders.
And they get so many attempts. Mia Robinson gets a lot of attempts every night.
Wildcats by three, set two. Great job by Lesiak. Or to the outside. Tip trying to pancake. That was bomber. Jones the kill. Great effort defensively, however, from the Wildcats.
Played a tipping for a while there on both sides of the net, seeing who's going to last the longest. I loved how Aubriana Cannon went down on her knees and set that ball. Doing anything for her team to try to get a kill, but Iowa came out on top.
Hawkeyes within two now. Set the middle to Olivia Viscuso. That is quick from Bomber.
That is really quick arm swing. You have to get up fast. You've got to show your arm to your setter. And you have to have a lot of confidence that she's going to give you that ball. Look at right between the seam of Amaya Jones and Bree Orr, not ready for it. And she's technically sound. She has all the tools that she needs to score. She's just not gifted enough to jump over those blockers. We've seen a lot of middle blockers in the Big Ten. So they need to find a way to make sure she's staying efficient out there and scoring when they need it.
Kill from Viscuso was the third service error from Northwestern. Bomber set up Cannon. Bomber this time pushes it to Gerback for the tip. Or to Taylor Lewis. Big swing right at Michelle Lee. Bump set from Bomber. Lindroth out of the back row. So Northwestern took set one up by three and set two on the road. Back at Carver Hawkeye, it's been an impressive showing so far from Northwestern. They've been really efficient offensively, Liz. How have they done that?
Well, they've been able to pass and give the ball up to Britt Bomber, where she's able to deliver the ball in all different areas of the court. I love how she's getting her middles involved as well. You know, longer hear so much about Nia Robinson, but Alana Walker, she's got it going, Aubriana Cannon, but this Viscuso, just the timing has been perfect of those points.
They've spread things around. Northwestern getting everyone involved to this point. Seven different players have combined on the 23 kills. Viscuso has served really tough tonight. She's got another ace serve.
Doing such a great job from the serving line. She really is. And this is somebody from Arlington, Texas. Been working really hard on this team in the front row and the back court. It's good to see it pay off in the third line.
Goes right on Callie Hoy again. Taylor Lewis blasted it at Lindroth. Free ball sent far and too long from Aubriana Cannon.
Jim Mike. This is some high ceilings in Carver Hawkeye.
A video board scraper right there from Cannon. 3-4 service. back set for Cannon, off the block, and out point to the Wildcats.
They're finding different ways to score, a lot of tool opportunities. Iowa had 23 blocks last time they played each other. They didn't develop that, the blocking, until later on into the match. I wonder if that's going to happen tonight.
Well, they only have one block so far. An ace serve, that is six of them for Northwestern. This one for Cannon.
Oh, this is huge for Aubrey McKenna to get back there, and she's serving from zone five, but really clips the tape and brings it up.
Wildcats won another set, off to a great start tonight. So we got to hit a home run serving, they have six aces so far.
Oh, they sure do, and Vizcuso is doing her part, but Britt Bomber as well. She has 10 aces on the season and less airs as well, but Northwestern is finding all areas of the court to score into, and Iowa needs to stop the bleeding.
I don't know if you caught that first ace, and speaking of caught, the band member caught the ball off the ace serve. How about that? Our great crew has it dialed up. Check this out. The cheerleading crew. I mean, there's a costume contest tonight for Halloween. I know he's in uniform, but we got to get this guy something.
Excellent job right there, really in tune to what's going on.
Well, Northwestern has had it all in tune so far tonight. The six ace serves, they do have three errors, but they've looked very difficult on Iowa's serve receive. Cannon goes at Molly Kelly this time. Reagan Coyle. Bump set from the libero lead. Her back cross court misses her mark. And Iowa trying to create some fuel right here to get within four.
You're exactly right, Mike. You have to create it yourself. And if you're trying to reach out to other people to do it for you, it's not going to work. Whoever's got a touch on the ball has got to make a positive touch. And then the next person's got to turn it into something better. It's called bettering the ball.
Free ball from Northwestern. Big swing,
Reagan
Coyle explodes into it.
And I love how Bree Orr is getting that tighter and tighter for Coyle because she's able to tool. Rebecca's late on that swing block over there, so she takes advantage of it and scores.
Between Foy and Coyle, that is 16 of Iowa's 20 kills. Taylor Lewis only has one. Bomber gave up the body but can't get there. And Iowa's on the run to get within two.
That's a good time out for Iowa trying to pump up their team. And you're right, Taylor Lewis was contained for sure last time they played against each other. Northwestern has figured them out.
So Shane Davis takes the timeout, and Iowa in this gym trying to get a win at home. They had the huge one just 2.5 weeks ago against Wisconsin. So they knock off a top 10 opponent. This was a big benchmark for Bonchamins.
Oh, it sure was. And they haven't beaten them in so many years. And Wisconsin was there to play. Don't get me wrong. They were there. They showed up and they were competing hard. But they didn't have an answer for the outside hitters of Taylor Lewis and Callie Hoy. Iowa just gritted their way back into that match. Every time they were down, they came from behind and found ways to score against a really strong opponent like Wisconsin.
Lewis had 24 kills in that match. We've made mention of this tonight. Callie Hoy had 30 kills in that match. And tonight, Hoy is driving Iowa. She's got 10 kills on 18 swings, hitting 333.
Well, you know, she's somebody that has really worked hard to earn this starting spot. A couple weeks into the season, she was able to produce for a team like Iowa, and she was sitting the bench the two seasons previous, really watching and waiting and training. And that's what you do as a bench player. You train every day, you work super hard in hopes that you get this opportunity to find a way on that starting side, and she sure has earned it, and she's doing a great job for Iowa. Let's see if she can really close in on Northwestern on this set.
10 kills tonight, 30 kills in that match. Her first 2 years in Iowa City, just 50 kills total. Up serve from Iowa, Gerbach. Kelly digs it. Lewis out of the back row. Lee on the overpass. Bump set from Kelly out to Coyle. Iowa on a 4-0 run.
And they'll get anybody fired up. I do like the dig on Northwestern side, but here Coyle again finding the seam, which is hard to do because Alana Walker almost closed that block.
And just when Iowa created the momentum, a service error from the Hawkeyes.
Yeah, that is a complete downer when you have those long rallies and really exciting stuff. But you got to be able to bounce back. Volleyball, you have to have a short memory out there because you're going to have that next play.
Lesiak serves well for Northwestern. Freshman went short.
It is fun to watch her because you hear that hard snap. She puts some heat on the ball, and she's really above her head when she has that hard snap. Most outside hitters keep the ball way out in front of their bodies. She kind of snaps it, so it is hard to tell if her blocker or she's going with it.
Picks up her 12th kill in a different way this time, and we are even in set two.
Great fast point opportunity, being ready for that overpass, just strong and being able to shove it down onto the court.
But the reactions as well from Callie Hoy, who is steering this 6-1 run for the Hawkeyes. Good serve from Iowa to take the lead.
Northwestern is really struggling with rotation. I like Molly Kelly back there on the serving line.
So Callie Hoy, Molly Kelly have the Hawkeyes back in front. For good ones on BTN, we've got a good one here in Iowa City with Halloween costumes a week early as well. A unicorn or two sightings today.
Yes, I believe that is a unicorn. I don't know what the guy next to him is.
Well, what Iowa is right now is on a run, a 3-0 scoring run to go up by one on Northwestern in set two, trying to pull even. Alana Walker, she has 7 kills to pace Northwestern.
And they like going that right side pin, Alana Walker, all night long, finding the open spot, but it starts with a good pass. The first ball side out opportunity, that's what teams always try to achieve. So their setter has 3 options out there.
Lee serves it toward Coyle, along the net, and a tip on the overpass, Reagan Coyle.
Great heads up play, just taking your arm out, making sure you can get that ball up by the right side. But Coyle was right there and able to hit Nia Robinson.
Again, we're a broken record, but it is Hoy and Coyle providing the points for Iowa. And it is served. Maddie Slagle, a freshman from Cedar Rapids.
This is what is really important on your home court. You've got to serve strong against any opponent when you have the opportunity in your own gym.
Nia Robinson gets the Wildcats back within one.
I like that deep corner edge, really finding a huge open spot on the court. You see Molly Kelly back there in that corner. She turns to face. Her range is not as big. The block for Iowa side likes to funnel that ball right into Molly Kelly. Nia Robinson did a nice job of making her move.
Or Seth Hoy. What do you know? She goes long. Back to Hoy. Tools the block with a line shot this time.
It's a fast transition for Hoy up there, getting off on 2 feet back and forth. Being patient and really driving hard. It's really speeds up her spike approach. The acceleration is really strong for her, and that's how she gets some of that power, some of that pace on the ball.
Above 400 late in set two. Point goes to Northwestern on the net violation, so it's a 1-point margin. Robinson behind the line to serve. Timeout, Iowa. Back and forth we go in set two, the Wildcats. And the Hawkeyes locked in a good one. Swings for Northwestern.
Well, she's getting the job done, that's for sure. 151 kills for the season for her. Very competitive, knows the game well. But Britt Bomber is given the ball that she needs in order to score, to put her in this position to be up 2-0.
The daughter of former NBA star Antoine Walker. Alana Walker played a big part so far in Northwestern's start here on the road in Iowa City. Those are the exemplary numbers from the sophomore, a product of Whitney Young in Chicago. So Northwestern really controlled set one. This set has been a little bit more back and forth, Liz, especially later on in this set. Robinson serves it Lewis. Taylor Lewis gets it back. Lee digs. Bump set from Bomber to Gerback. Roll shot dug. Lewis again. Off the block. Lee sets Cannon. Back row attack. Boy for the kill. And set point on the way for Iowa.
That was a great rally by both sides. Just keeping the ball alive and really waiting their time to score. I like Hoy out of the backcourt because she brings that speed and that pace. It's perfect timing by Bree Orr to give her that ball.
So a chance here for Iowa to pull even. Allie Johnston is coming to serve. Bomber sets her back. Off the block. 24-all.
Her back coming up big right now for that kill. Northwestern's bench is really pushing and talking their way on the road. Not easy to do.
Excuse me. Taylor Lewis is blocked.
Well, with authority, that is for sure, Mike. Everyone knows where that ball is going, but that was a solid block. A little tight to the net. But when that ball's tight, you've got to get those hands over, and that is exactly what Walker did.
Or Seth Lewis. Coverage off the block. Hoy out of the back row is in for the kill.
Hoy saying, let's go to her teammate. She wants that ball in every opportunity, and why not give it to her at this point, Mike?
Doesn't feel like everything's going right for Callie Hoy. She has been spectacular. Northwestern on the system. Free ball from Gerback. Or
that was a great change up. Defensively, Northwestern is back on their heels, not expecting a shot at all in the middle of the court in the donut area. Iowa's able to score.
Second set point for the Hawkeyes. Bomber sets the middle to Walker. Back and forth we go.
And that's not something Walker likes to do as much as of the setter. There was a nice gap play right there, away from the setter. Walker is more comfortable going off of 1 foot.
She's up to 8 kills, tied with Nia Robinson for a team high. Cannon serves. Tough one is Ollie Kelly. Back row four. Kelly Hoy. Tied him up 16 kills.
I'm really surprised that Northwestern is not getting more blockers. Envoy out of the back row. I'm trying to adjust that way.
So a third set point. Taylor Lewis serves. Bump set from Bomber. Gerback off some hands. 27-all.
Side out volleyball right here, Mike. Could strum up 2 points in a row right now.
After Northwestern took set one, 25-15.
This is where where your defense really needs to stand out. And a nice touch up there, a transition convert.
Iowa's been trying to clean up the serve-receive as well tonight against Northwestern. Here's Annalisia. Or in system, sets the middle. Lee Duggan is out in Iowa by one.
We're here to see some great action. Molly Kelly getting her platform out right away, but Coyle's coming in. Oh, we got Clayton as well doing a crossbody shot.
Freshman middle from Bloomington, Illinois. Fourth set point. Back and forth, Northwestern with a response, and Nia Robinson bringing the energy.
She is right now. Those 2 points in a row, we've got to find them somewhere from some edge, but one-on-one opportunity against Nia Robinson is not going to do it for Iowa. She finds an easy kill.
Michelle Lee. Who's that boy on the overpass? Right there for Viscuso.
That was a huge serve for Northwestern, just to put Iowa out of system and being physical at the net. Getting that fast point opportunity for the set point.
It's been more than a year since Northwestern's taken the first two sets of a Big Ten match on the road. Trying to do that here in Iowa City. Callie Hoy has other ideas as she has all night 17 kills on 26 swings.
But I'd like to see Northwestern find a way to get Callie Hoy out of the conversation. You see Britt Bomber out there giving her a little bit too much line, not even adjusting on the block.
Breaking Coyle. Robinson. Or back to Hoy. Bomber sets Robinson again. Lee. Bomber to the dunk. Bump set from Orr to the back row. One of the longer rallies tonight, Robinson. Orr to the dunk. Capped up by Northwestern. Off the free ball. Orr back to Hoy. Four of those shots down the line, and it's out. Didn't miss by a whole lot, and perhaps we'll see a green card.
This might be a good time to take out that green card. I was watching digs on both sides of the net. Here we see the down the line shot.
Sure looks out.
Definitely out from this angle.
Well, Bozumanski has shown the green card and challenging. Challenge this year in the CRS in college volleyball. Touches and in and out calls.
You've done a lot of volleyball matches this year, Mike. So what do you think about the challenge system?
Well, what I will say about the challenge system is doing all these matches hasn't increased how many I predict right when we go to the challenge.
That's right. I was waiting for that. I have not done so well either, even though we see a great shot by the production crew.
Let's see if there's a touch here. Off that right hand, the bomber, perhaps? So the call is confirmed. It doesn't stand. They confirm that it is out, and therefore no touch either. So the point to Northwestern after our first challenge from either side tonight. So as we thought, certainly out. And now Shane Davis getting his lineup sorted out.
Well, it definitely was a good break to take for Iowa. Catch their breath and to figure things out.
They need to side out here. Or, who else but Hoy down the line? Hoy, Iowa on the double contact. They do side out once again.
That was a great dig, too, down the line. Just couldn't handle the speed coming off the platform of a bomber to make sure that ball goes straight up.
So how would you defend Callie Hoy differently? You can commit block, but we've seen her out of the back row as well.
volleyball, you've got to make sure you're right side blocker. I would say get all the way to the pin and maybe be a little bit more patient and press into the court.
All set from the libero, Kelly to Taylor Lewis. Cannon is blocked, point Iowa.
Boy, how things turn fast. Yeah, bomber up there, but look at that shot by Abriana Cannon, just trying to tool and drag it out of bounds, but Iowa did not have that at all. Straight down.
Four to the back row for Kelly Boyd, and Iowa takes set two. They were down five in this set at one point. They come all the way back. We had a combined 8 set points, and the Hawkeyes pull it out. Northwestern in set one, and then in a deuce set, Iowa takes the second game.
That was a great ending for Iowa right here. Of course, none other than Kelly Hoy going for that attack, cross body.
All right, we're with Northwestern head coach Shane Davis. And coach, the result aside there at the end, what have you liked from winning set one and the resiliency in set two?
Yeah, absolutely. We're doing a nice job, like you said, with resiliency and kind of set the tone with aggressive play. We got to do a better job with our blockers, slowing down number 14 tomorrow right now. She's heating up, and we're just getting in a poor spot with our block right now, but we've got to figure out an answer for her.
Shane, you mentioned earlier on that you needed to work really hard on the serve and pass game for your squad. How do you think you're doing tonight in that area?
Yeah, we're passing really well, which is giving our setter a lot of options right now. We're hitting, I think, 390 maybe as a team, so it's a pretty good clip for us right now. Serving-wise, we're doing a good job, except thought Iowa did an outstanding job late in that set, passing really well. So I think when we get a little bit tight in that score, we've got to pick up our aggressive serving late in sets.
Thank you, Shane. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
All right, that's Wildcats head coach Shane Davis, whose team got off to a great start in set one. There's been a lot of juice inside Carver Hawkeye. Iowa took set two. This team has won one set so far back in Iowa City at Carver Hawkeye Arena, where moments ago we caught up with Iowa head coach Bon Schimanski. All right, and Bon, we're trying to find some superlatives to describe Kelly Hoy. Can you help us out on her performance so far?
She's fantastic. You know, she's been great for us all year, and as my cousin Rob said, like, she's just a go-to hitter, fired up, really carrying us right now. We need Taylor Lewis to step it up to that notch. Like what we're getting out of Reagan Quo, we just got to get her the ball more, but it's really all serving passing right now, and this is so similar to when we played them last time. We just didn't play well first set, squeaked out a tight second set. Hopefully it'll finish the way it did in Evanston, but we got a lot of work to do as a unit.
Could be a long way to go. Coach, thanks so much for the time.
Thanks.
All right, so Kelly Hoy with 18 kills. The verdict is that she is fantastic. Reagan Coyle, they want to get her the ball even more because she's been so efficient.
Well, over 40 attempts for these two. They're getting all the balls on the Iowa side. And understandably, Coach wants Taylor Lewis to step up. But how about their middles? And that's something that they wanted to do early on. But the third and pass game takes over. And that's something that you really need to clean up on both sides of the court in order to produce.
So Northwestern cruised comfortably in set one. Both teams battled in set two, but Iowa pulled it out 32-30. We begin the second half of this Big Ten season, and Liz Tortorella Nelson, we began the night saying that both these teams feel that they're primed in the second half to take steps forward with where their programs have been.
Well, it starts tonight for sure, and they both want this W on the record.
Megan Buzerio in the serve for Iowa. And then she can't handle the big swing from Alana Walker, who has 9 kills on 13 attacks.
And this probably started that first set. Automatic kill by Alana Walker going behind the setter for that big kill downstairs.
Bon Schimanski said it's all serving and passing. Tough pass there from Kelly. Orr handled it. Got a swing for Orr. What a kill.
That was a good out-of-system kill by Nia Robinson. That ball's around the 10-foot line. That was not close enough to the net at all. Brick Armour really pushing it. But she is just wheeling that ball over the net. Nice, strong arm. Got a lot of pace on it.
Good pass from Kelly. Off the block. Coil denied.
She's trying to go for that hard angle. But what middle blockers can do so well is they can drop their hand. And you see right there, Viscuso is pulling up and making sure she's nice and big with that block. And hands over the net.
Just the second hitting error tonight from Reagan Coyle. The top pass from Iowa. Lisette Robinson. 4-0 start for the Wildcats in set three.
Well, you've got to come out of the gate fast against a team like Iowa because they're going to turn around and be able to catch it up on that serving line, which we saw towards the end of that last set.
Lee. Better pass this time from Rosario. Boy, a rarity not in rhythm.
A little flat right there for Boy. The set dropped a little bit. She wasn't able to get that next step to the ball to get a high point of contact swing, which she likes to do behind her head.
Still hitting an impressive 375. Kelly with a good pass to Orr. Boy is blocked. What a start for Northwestern in set three.
Huge start. Nice block by the setter, Britt Bomber. Holding her ground and just pressing over the net.
It was Iowa that had 23 blocks in the first meeting. It's all about the Northwestern block in set three. Wildcats up 6-0. Northwestern trying to start its climb up the ladder of the Big Ten in the second half of the season. A really good beginning to set three, up 6-0. A lot of it has come with Michelle Lee serving. Freshman walk-on libero from Naperville, Illinois. Gets Iowa out of system again. Rosario off the mark, and it's 7-0 Wildcats at the outset.
They're hitting negative right now, and it's amazing the game of volleyball. The ebb and flow of the rhythm. You saw they came out such a high of winning that last set, and here you go, down by 7.
Passing really hasn't been the issue so far in set 3 for Iowa. Or on the back set. Bomber sets Robinson. There's the block for Iowa to get going. We told you before the break, 23 blocks in the first meeting at the end of September. Just the fourth block tonight.
Well, Clayton held her ground and she really pressed into the court. Nia Robinson didn't have a lot of options on that one to do a cross body. She needed to go wrist away shot. Iowa came up big with that block to stop the bleeding.
And Brett Bomber sets Nia Robinson, who's got a team-high 12 kills.
I love how she always goes back to her as well. And Nia Robinson is somebody that's not getting two or having two errors in a row as an outside hitter. And let's not pretend here. Outside hitters get a lot of garbage out there. But Brett Bomber is finding a way for her outside hitters to score.
Iowa out of system again. Bump set from Orr prompts the swing long. And Northwestern's up 9-1 in set 3. Von Szymanski said it's passing and serving. And Shane Davis said we pass so well that the corner's able to distribute well as the center. Bump set to the back row on the overpass after Lisiak got to it. It's out and the points of the Hawkeyes.
It was good for Iowa to get out of that rotation. Britt Bomber's been doing a nice job in their rotation one, serving a lot of points. But on the other side, Northwestern needs to take advantage of somebody like Britt Bomber back there and keep her back there as long as possible. Do not let Iowa get off the hook. Some of those rotations.
How about that for Iowa?
Huge block for Iowa, getting back on track. Finding a rhythm up there at the net. Continuing to be physical is really important for Iowa.
Northwestern by six. Bomber to Cannon. Hey, Friday on BTN, we've got another spectacular doubleheader of volleyball coming your way. The Gophers try to remain unbeaten in Big Ten play. They battle the Spartans. Then it's Dana Redke leading the Badgers against Carly Scott and the Wolverines. Liz will have that one. It's Big Ten volleyball powered by American Ethanol. Friday right here on BTN and the Fox Sports app. When we say Dana Redke, we should say the reigning national player of the week. Dana Redke, who had a big weekend up in Madison, helping steer the Badgers to a huge win over Nebraska.
Oh, just look at those stats right there. Really impressive for somebody to walk away with this honor, with such high-quality teams out there to choose from. Congratulations to Dana Redke and the whole team for making this possible.
Long rally here. Right at the net. Kelly throws over the free ball. Bomber sets Gerback. Line shot for Tally Hoy. 19 kills.
That's what she likes to do. She likes to find that ball right on that pin and either tool the block or find that deep line. I love how Molly Kelly's involved in every play possible for Iowa to get this going, but it was a nice long rally with Hoy coming up big.
Nice dig in there from Kelly as well, the senior, who is second in the Big Ten in digs per set behind only Jenna Lurd of Michigan. Well, Cannon is really impressive when she gets going. That's two big kills from her.
Yeah, it was huge, too. Right down the line, really fast arm swing. Not a lot of time to set up as a blocker. Defensively, you've got to keep your eyes on the ball at all times or protect your face, Mike.
See if Taylor Lewis can get going. That's just her second kill on 17 swings.
Coach has said that in the break, making sure she's got to find some action up there. The team is going to do a better job, too, when she's on the floor delivering a good ball, maybe a dig transition game for her. Find a way to get involved.
Lewis, of course, is the NCAA leader in career kills, more than 1,800. Good tip from Northwestern.
That was really smart by Quebec. Going after Amaya Jones back there after she served. I have a wonder, too. Middles are back there to serve, but we also have to play defense, too, Mike. You can't just serve and expect to stand there and not, you know, let the game go by you. So you've got to get involved, but it was really smart from Northwestern.
It's the fourth service error for Northwestern. That one from Sarah Johnson. Chemansky's team, inch by inch, trying to fight back into set three. Four serves. Bomber to Gerback. Kelly's overpass. Bomber back to the freshman. Gerback cross court.
Oh, the sharp cross court. Ripped away. Angle. Molly Kelly couldn't get her hands on it. Second time around, but really outside her body line. Really tough to block. You want to line up nose on the ball, Mike, but that ball is outside. So good job by Ella Gerback to get things going again for Northwestern.
The daughter of Elvis, of course, former Michigan quarterback. Had a great career in the NFL. Kill for Hoy. And the Hawkeyes within seven.
Right now, Hoy's got 10 kills with 18 attempts. For a high percentage. We haven't heard her name called in quite some time, so it's good to see her get back on the board.
Boyle up to 10 kills now. Mia Robinson tools the block.
I like that first ball side out. Good pass right there for Britt Bomber. Even though Iowa's block knew where the ball was going, Mia Robinson is still able to power through and use the tool opportunity on the right side hand.
Kelly, a tough serve. Nicely done by Lee. What Northwestern has done tonight.
And Lee's been back there quite often for Northwestern. To really stir things up. It's great to be back there on that serving line multiple times. Staying in this rotation.
Kelly committed to the Wildcats back in January. We told you she's a walk-on. She takes this one. Northwestern keeps it up and over.
Good decision by Bree Orr to go behind her head and go to Coyle. Molly Kelly takes it nice and high, but Viscusa was late inside set. I like to say kaboom.
Michelle Lee, Robinson. Well timed on the line shot. You said it, outside hitters often get a lot of junk. Robinson's done well with it.
She has. Right now she's sitting for a very high percentage for somebody like Mia Robinson. Normally on the year she's hitting around 200, but she gets a lot of kills per set, and that's where she really stands out.
3.97 kills per set for the sophomore out of Indianapolis. Callie Orr.
Back on track. I like the pass and swing options. She stays in motion there. Northwestern really needs to take her out of the situation. And a lot of times teams will serve at that outside hitter, Mike, and make them go into a different direction than where they're headed. Maybe that's next time they'll be here.
Well, she goes right back to the same spot. Rolls it into that far corner, now 21.
Rolled it with some authority back there in the edge of the court. Tough to defend in that back, that deep corner, almost high over the block with that high snap.
Third time in her career she has eclipsed 20 kills in a match. They've all come this season. Northwestern responds, gets the margin back up to 8.
I'm really happy for her setter, Britt Bomber, for taking that ball out of the net, not attacking it, going up high and finding Viscuso for that kill.
And how good has the passing been from Northwestern? Bomber is already up and over 40 assists.
I think they're doing a great job, and just like Coach Davis said, she's able to distribute it so evenly.
Lee with one arm. Free ball is out from Viscuso.
Just the communication alone. A lot of talk, a lot of chatter on the Northwestern side. Now, Iowa needs to get that back. We heard them coming alive toward the end of that second set by a couple of their players. Taylor Lewis, now that is in the front row, we hope that she gains some momentum. Iowa needs to get some points on the board.
Well, Abriana Cannon gives Northwestern the 19-11 lead in set 3.
Well, Cannon right now waits patiently. Britt Bomber reverses the ball to her, so the Iowa block is a little late. A lot of court to hit into. I know, absolutely. Northwestern is really getting it done. And we've talked about this, Mike. Is it something they're just really good at, the serving line, or Iowa is just not ready to pass?
Either way, it adds up to a whole lot of success for Northwestern in set 3. 3-9 on Iowa as the Wildcats try to build off that big win we told you about Friday at home against Michigan State. The first half of their Big Ten schedule was very difficult, to put it lightly. 7 ranked teams already in conference play. And Northwestern has something to look forward to as well. They're going to get into Welsh Ryan after one more match away from there at home. And then they get in their new home the rest of the year.
Well, they've been playing at Evanston Township High School, which is not far from their real home, and their last match there is coming up on the weekend. But how exciting for them to get to find a home and to get into their new arena.
For Maya Jones for Iowa. Yeah, we talked to Shane Davis about it, and Northwestern got to go in there to practice yesterday. He said when the team just got into the lobby, they loved the new car smell. They loved the whole place just based on seeing the lobby, not even the locker room.
Well, how could you not? They've been displaced for so long, and this group is really special that they've been able to manage being on the road for 14 matches straight in the beginning of the season, not to mention alone last year, and being kind of displaced again, you know, outside of their arena while Welsh Ryan was getting converted and remodeled. So huge kudos to this group and really leading the way for the next generation in Northwestern.
With the kill. tonight on 18 swings, now hitting positive.
And this is somebody that transferred from Marquette, somebody that was an All-American status at Marquette, swing big numbers and just wanted something a little bit more, wanted to be more in the Big Ten in this national arena. She's got expectations to play at an even higher level when she's done. She wants to play professionally. A lot to work on her game, but she definitely has a swing to go pretty far.
Her Hawkeyes within seven. Nice job handling the tip. Gerbach's tip. And it's off the antenna, point Hawkeyes. Well, we talked about Lewis, and we talked about Evanston Township High School. Lewis from Evanston, Illinois. We'll get into more of that after this timeout. The Hawkeyes here within by six. Lewis has started to get going a little bit. Hoy has the 21 kills. Hoyle with 11. But if Iowa wants to go on a run, they could really use Taylor Lewis.
No, they sure can. And she's somebody that has really dug them out of a hole. She knows how to hit her way out of a hole. And she can do that. They've got a lot more volleyball to play. And she's somebody that's a stellar athlete. Right from the get-go, Von Schmansky actually recruited her. And when he was at Marquette, and she kind of followed along with him.
Well, we told you that she's from Evanston, Illinois. The first meeting between these teams was, of course, back in Evanston. And how about the turnout to watch Taylor Lewis in her homecoming? I love to see that.
Oh, this is great, and this is what you want. Every time you're on the road, of course, as a player, you want to see friends and family join you in your successes and just watch you play, and that's huge, and that's such a great photo of her and her family and friends.
You mentioned how she had a great few years at Marquette, redshirt in her first year after Von Schmansky had recruited her. Between what she did at Marquette and now what she's done in two seasons at Iowa, nobody currently active in the NCAA has more career kills.
Oh, how about that? Really impressive, and there's more to come for sure for Taylor Lewis. A lot more volleyball to be played this season. It's something they're really looking forward to. A lot of these matches coming up against unranked opponents where they have opportunities and advantages to find the W.
When Von Schmansky was recruiting her the first time, spotted her and said she was the very definition of raw at that point, but he saw the athleticism, he saw the competitive drive. Boy, she had an excellent career at a couple stops. The Northwestern by six in set three, but double contact gives some more momentum to Iowa.
And they're looking for these unforced errors by Northwestern to keep them in the set. Keep three or back there on the serving line.
Bomber Seth Walker. Tag error. We hadn't called Walker's name in a little bit, and she's off the mark. 5-0 run and a timeout. Shane Davis wants to talk it over with the Hawkeyes within four in set three at home. For blow with Northwestern here in set three, the Hawkeyes have got back within four after Northwestern got out to such a good start in set three. The Hawkeyes feel like they're ready to make a move as well in the second half of the Big Ten season. Much like Northwestern, tough first half. They did have a huge win over Wisconsin. They're going to be here at Carver Hawkeye a lot down the stretch.
Well, and that's what they're looking forward to. They like the momentum. Serving line right here by Bree Orr. She's got to stay back there. And this is their home court. They've got to take advantage of every opportunity that they have.
And if you're Northwestern, too, you want to find a way to close out a set here because they were up late in set two by as many as five.
You'll hear coaches often say, we need to find a way to win. We need to learn how to win. And Northwestern, they learned how to win a lot in the preseason, but they haven't won a lot in conference, so it takes a little bit more time. You got to get back on track those winning ways.
Nice dig by Lee. Robinson. Long.
Little bit, Mike, with those errors, something that Shane Davis had said to us, got to make sure this is not happening, especially at this point in the match where you need to sustain, find some consistency, and compete.
Well, Nia Robinson with an answer for Northwestern. Cross court right at Molly Kelly.
Again, Britt Conner finds her twice in a row, and she's able to score on the second time around.
Northwestern still hitting above 300. They're at 320 for the match. Michelle Lee has been dangerous serving. Four sets, Callie Hoy. Robinson, stepped up by Iowa. Palmer back to Robinson. Another kill. 16 for Robinson, and set point for Northwestern.
And Robinson, it's a good thing Northwestern has her in the front row right now, and especially Michelle Lee on the serving line.
So much of this for the Wildcats tonight has been with Lee and Viscuso serving. Northwestern had set point three times in set two. First try in set three. Off the block, tapped up. Nice job by Johnson for Iowa. Bomber to Robinson for the kill. Set three to Northwestern.
Now that was a great way to finish for Northwestern. Nia Robinson really finding her groove. 17 kills so far for the evening.
In any one set this season for Nia Robinson. She's got 17 for the match. Two sets for Northwestern. Robinson, she has seven of them in set three.
Well, she's doing a great job, and somebody we're used to seeing out there scoring away, but she does a wrist-away shot, she does lines, and she finds the middle of the court for those hard-driven kills just when her teammates need it.
Hitting 375. She's done it when Northwestern's been out of system. Bomber has found her in system as well.
And they know how to rely on her, and she comes through, and I just love the fact that the setter will always find her. Even if she made an error, she's not going to make two errors in a row. She's a very consistent player.
One of the big things that Shane Davis said to us about Nia Robinson is, as this year's gone along, more so in transition, she's found a better groove with Britt Palmer. That's something maybe they didn't have the best connection on earlier in the year. Hannah Lesiak starts out serving again in set four. Northwestern up 2-1 on the road here in Carver Hawkeye. Overpass off the dig. Lesiak's free ball. Or sets up Reagan Coyle.
That's a fast tempo as well. I'm watching Clayton get up, hoping that Iowa finds their middles, but there's Reagan Coyle getting up almost on a first tempo ball behind the setter, delivering the kill. Now Iowa's on the board. It's good to see.
33 of the 43 Iowa kills are from Hoy and Coyle. There's Hoy, teeing off down the line. Lesiak right by the bench. Free ball. Or sets Coyle. Bomber to Robinson. Line shot for the kill.
And that is another fast tempo out there. I love how they're running everything so smooth. Nia Robinson doesn't have a lot of time for that big transition ball. She just gathers her body up on a two-step and delivers.
Northwestern still as a team hitting 333. Boy, it was a little bit more quiet in set three compared to the first two sets tonight. Robinson gets an order. Top three ball. Robinson. Nia Robinson has 19 kills for Northwestern.
I love the scrappy play on both sides, but how about Sarah Johnson laying out for this ball to keep it nice and high so that Nia Robinson could get that final kill. Sarah Johnson used to be a libero for Northwestern. She's got a lot of experience back there, and it really showed.
Callie Hoy gets the point for Iowa off the touch.
Looking for that high ball, big high snap right in front of her.
Sarah Johnson not able to get to it.
22 is the running tally for Callie Hoy. And for Nia Robinson, it's now 20. She has been excellent the last two sets.
An outside hitter versus an outside hitter game going, something that these teams practice every day in the gym.
You know, tonight we tried to be different. We started by talking about the right sides on both teams, but who could avoid it that we'd eventually be talking left side? There's Hoy. Off the block, good coverage. Kelly gets to it. Free ball for Moore. Cannon. Off the mark, Point Iowa.
Sometimes you go for those hard angle shots, but great coverage ball. Look at Molly Kelly really lay out for this. Off of a free ball, you would expect Northwestern to score, and Adriana Cannon has got a lot of options. Next time she'll go for the easier one down the middle.
Yeah, she's been really efficient tonight. Just her third error. After Hoy's dig, she gets a back row swing. Northwestern sets the middle to Viscuso.
And Bree Orr's in on the action for the block and was able to get tool, but she read it well, and that's part of the blocking system that both of these teams have. They can read, they commit. Sometimes they shave, do a little jab step, Mike. Iowa looks like they're reading really well, just trying to get touches.
Boy. Northwestern.
And you notice the difference there. They had a couple blockers up on Hoy, where before they only had one. So eventually they want something to turn into that, maybe a better transition, a better touch, so they can dig and transition and execute.
Or to Taylor Lewis on the overpass. Bomber sets her back. Four back to Lewis. Cross court, excellent shot on a sharp angle.
That was a sharp angle, and you see her body coming right at us. Good set all the way out there for Taylor Lewis. Really passed up the block and just was able to swing away.
And denied.
Something you don't want to do is slow down your approach. Move your body to the ball and find a way to keep the ball in play for your teammate.
Amaya Jones serving with Iowa on a 3-0 run. Four to the middle. Very quick. To Hannah Clayton, the freshman.
Hannah Clayton's been watching Callie Hoy for a little bit, getting those tool options.
Hawkeyes on a 4-0 run, up by three in set four. Volleyball on BTN is presented by State Farm, here to help life go right. Talk to a State Farm agent today. Hello from Iowa City. Hawkeyes on a 4-0 run, up by three in set four. Trying to force a fifth set tonight against Northwestern. Liz Bordarello, Nelson, Mike Monaco, our entire BTN crew with you from Carver Hawkeye. Ella Gerback takes a rip right at Hoy, middle back.
Yeah, Hoy was starting to cheat up a little bit in the middle back position, and the back got her. Really reaching high, almost a flat ball. Not a lot of topspin, but a lot of heat.
Eight kills now for Gerback. Scusa has been great serving all night. Attack error from Taylor Lewis.
One thing I have noticed on Iowa's side of the net is Bree Orr is moving efficiently, but she's forgetting to take that last step to really square up for her hitters like a Taylor Lewis. It's not completely going in the angle that she needs it. That's a better ball right there.
It leads to a Lewis kill, her fifth tonight. On 21 swings, let's break this down how she set.
And it's just it's something I noticed because I like footwork coming from my setters. She got her feet there and was really able to square her hips over to Taylor Lewis in the set before. She did not square her hips up, so the ball comes up ever so slightly.
So it's very slight, but it's just something I noticed in the setter position.
Part of the evolution for Bree Orr stepped in last year as the true freshman, the setter for Iowa. She has really grown coming into this year with the coaching staff for the Hawkeyes.
Oh, it's huge right now for both sides of the court, those assistant coaches and what they do on a daily basis or even in-game management. It's really important. You see a setting coach, you see a middle hitting coach, defensive coach. They all have their different roles. But it's the everyday that they go through and the training process that they work individually with those coaches to help them out.
Point was initially signaled to Northwestern, and now our R1 and R2 are going to come together. Von Szymanski is fired up on the sideline. Set four. Sarah Johnson serves. Four. This time on the slide to Coyle.
That ball went straight down. No block in sight. It's almost like a teeter-totter motion. You can see right here, grab goes up and down. Bad timing on her point. Great kill for Coyle.
Well, you get her one-on-one, too. Pretty good feed from Orr. Hawkeyes by three. Burback. Trigger's long. Hawkeyes by four now.
Burback, you've got to be able to flush those mistakes. She knew she was off on that block and had an opportunity to score in the next ball. And that's something that she's going to learn as she moves through her career.
Ace serve for Iowa. Just the third tonight. Allie Johnston. And a timeout, Northwestern. Iowa with a surge in set four on a 5-1 run. Some late night volleyball action in this midweek conference matchup from Carver Hawkeye Arena. Hawkeyes up by five in set four against Northwestern. So we start the second half of the Big Ten regular season, and both these teams with more favorable schedules hoping to climb up and get with all those ranked teams at the top.
And this is what they want, exactly. It's setting up perfectly for these two teams, starting with the battle tonight. But they're looking forward to it. They both feel pretty good about where they're at right now and their competition moving forward. But the Big Ten is no joke. It's definitely a grind every night. You've got to show up no matter if you're home or away.
After a nice tumbling dig from Molly Kelly, point to Iowa.
Clayton is doing her part up there in the middle. Need to get more involved for Iowa. We've seen more and more out of her out of the front row.
Bomber on the back set to Alana Walker. That is really nicely done.
Perfectly set play. Great up by Allie Lindroth, really pushing Britt Bomber in front so she can go against the grain and make the middle blocker on the other side of the net move to Alana Walker.
And Britt Bomber is already working on a career high, 53 assists now in the middle of set four. Robinson got to it. Free ball from Lesiak. They set the middle. Hannah Clayton.
There's a great defensive effort for Northwestern. Get a little touch off the block, a little touch off of Michelle Lee, but look at that one arm swing by Mia Robinson. On the other side, Clayton was able to finish it.
Bomber on a back set again to Walker, went line this time, and on the overpass, collects the kill, her 12th.
Northwestern is going to have to gain some momentum back there on the serving line with their friend Michelle Lee, trying to keep her back there, especially with Mia Robinson in the front row still.
Northwestern has 9 aces against 4 service errors. 4 sets, Callie Hoy rips it at Lee for the kill. Callie Hoy's had 51 swings, she has 24 kills.
And she's still jumping. She still has energy in those legs.
She's reaching high. That was actually a good up by Michelle Lee. The transition game off of Northwestern was just a little too slow to get.
Bomber to the rear dump. Her second kill tonight.
Iowa positioned themselves really well to get those attacks right in the middle of the court.
Bomber with a good serve. Iowa's out of system. Callie Hoy tools the block anyway.
Back to her bread and butter, which is the line shot. Finding little ways to score.
Most kills in a match this season. She is in the company that she was already in of Big Ten players this season. Robinson, we told you earlier, had 25, the first meeting between these two. Dug by Lee. Cannon. Nice response from Northwestern. They're hanging around here in set 4 within 5.
Oh, I love it. We got 15 digs by Michelle Lee. Having a stellar night. Making things happen for Northwestern.
She's been a big piece for them. She walked into the gym, and pretty quickly they figured out what she'd get out of this team. Lewis. Bomber sets from the back to Gerback. Off the block and down. Ninth kill for Gerback.
Again, she's just busting through that block. Out of system play, keeps the ball in front of her. Really goes after it with the last.
Robinson, the service error. Edwin Northwestern, clawing closer.
It's hard to swallow sometimes when you're back there after a nice play. You want to reward your hitters in the front row. Knowing Nia Robinson, she'll have another shot.
Maya Jones serves it at Lindroth, forces Northwestern out of system. So a free ball for Iowa to the middle, dug by Lindroth. Free ball from Orr. Bomber sets Gerback cross court in. Ella Gerback into double figures.
Ooh, a lot of range by Ella Gerback. Good to see up there. Last time around, really going after the block and the seam. This time, a nice wrist-away shot going for that deep perimeter shot.
So Gerback and Walker, they've been some of the supplementary pieces around Nia Robinson tonight. Nicely done by Orr, but just out. She thought she had it too.
She did. She was being really aggressive at the net. It's too bad she couldn't be rewarded for that. Keep being an offensive threat, the setters on both sides of the net. Really need to establish themselves to take some of the pressure off their pin hitter.
Bomber goes back to the bench. Free ball. Orr pushes it to Lewis for the kill. Taylor Lewis starting to get going later in this match, now with 6 kills.
Just taking care of the ball. When Northwestern gives Iowa those free balls, especially multiple free balls in the same rally, Iowa needs to terminate every time.
Bump set from Bomber. Cannon out of the back.
Little rotational defense by Iowa, splitting the court so the middle back is completely open. Cannon finding that open spot.
Freshman from Novi, Michigan, was originally committed to Notre Dame. She was high school teammates with Erin O'Leary. Stud recruit sitting behind Mackenzie Welsh at Michigan. Iowa back in business, up by 4 with Coyle.
Come on.
just been very steady all night long.
She had 18 kills in the first meeting, 15 tonight. Bomber to Walker. Maybe not the best pass, but Northwestern did well with it.
And it doesn't matter. A lot of Walker is going to work for that ball every time, running all the way from the left side of the court in that rotation to swing around behind the setter to find that big windup. Ball put down. Nice kill by Alana Walker to get things going for Northwestern.
Four to Hoy. Point goes to Northwestern. Just out and no touch. And Von Szymanski is wasting no time. Green card at the ready. And he uses his second challenge.
Well, he definitely has to use it. Everyone was kind of paused and looking at the line judge or the up rep. Might be just a nice little break for both of these teams.
So we'll have a couple looks at this. Again, the call gave the point to Northwestern. Certainly looks in.
Definitely was in. Let's see if they get this call right. Good challenge by Von, from what you and I saw, Mike.
Which he cannot take as gospel. And so the point does go to the Hawkeyes. So Von Szymanski successful in his challenge.
Great point up there defensively. The app was not able to move to her left side.
So Bond is one of two on his challenges. Shane Davis just got the explanation. His team down by four in set four. Bonner on a back set to Walker. Long and the point to Iowa. Northwestern thinking maybe there was a touch there, and that's exactly what Shane Davis challenges.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it, Mike?
I'll toss back the question you asked me earlier. What do you think of the challenge review system?
I think it's much better this year than it was last year. And I don't know if it's some of the changes that they made.
Challenging the touch, as we said here. So Wildcats within three. Four sets away. Took a big rip right at Lee. Northwestern nearly kept it up, but Iowa's ahead by four.
Just ready and waiting at the net, being physical. Almost expecting an overpass opportunity to put that ball away. But being very physical tonight, something that she normally does for this Iowa team.
She's got 16 kills now as Maddie Slagle serves. Tip from Robinson, handled by Slagle. Hoist tip. High free ball from Lee. Pushed out to Hoy. Bomber to Robinson. Bump set back to Hoy. A lot of swings in the rally, and Hoy taps it off.
Big out of system play on Iowa to finish it, but huge pass for Bree Orr across the court. Kelly Hoy being patient
and swings away. You've got to swing with authority no matter what, even if you're off the net.
Coverage off the block, but Iowa is ahead by six.
And they really pulled away from Northwestern, inch by inch. Get some good action up there at the net, especially by Callie Hoy.
It's a 4-1 run for Iowa. Four to the top, Lee digs it. Robinson. Four to Hoy. Blocked again. Point Iowa.
It was definitely a tool. Northwestern was right there, ready and waiting. But Callie Boy again does what she does best and tools the block.
Bump set from Bomber to Robinson. Set point for Iowa. To the middle. And Iowa pulls even. Amaya Jones out of the middle.
It was a huge win for Iowa to get some momentum to go into this fifth set.
Second match between these two in the month. And for the second time, we go five sets. Northwestern and Iowa duking it out at Carver Hawkeye. Sets apiece as we head to the fifth set in Iowa City. A good Big Ten match between Northwestern and Iowa. The Hawkeyes had a great set number four thanks to Callie Hoy.
Well, she's getting it done on all angles of the court, and her friend Bree Orr is finding her in these special opportunities. 28 kills for the evening, getting very close to her career best. And she gets it down by tooling the outside hitter's hand.
16 from Coyle as well. They have two-thirds of the production in terms of the kills for Iowa. You mentioned that Hoy's approaching that career high when she had 30 against Wisconsin. Von Schumanski called that one Herculean. We're going to have to think of some other Greek mythology if Hoy goes a little bit better here.
Well, he's going to find his friend Rob.
Cousin Rob.
Cousin Rob, to ask him about his, you know, his perception or his viewpoint on Callie Hoy. And she's doing such a great job. It's hard not to miss somebody like her in the front court.
Got to dig a little deeper into the thesaurus with Callie Hoy this year.
I love how that is a little tight, but she likes it like that. She really knows to go up hard and uses those hands from Northwestern to get her way.
For all we've said about Hoy, Boyle's been excellent as well. We just showed you the graphic. She's hitting 500 as well. Double contact called on Molly Kelly, the libero.
We haven't talked that much about Molly Kelly, but boy, she's done a nice job. Career leader, close to five digs per set this season. Kind of a spark plug for Iowa, grew up only about 20 miles away.
Exactly like Coyle, who goes to the tip. Former walk-on turned starter, turned scholarship player, turned captain.
There's a lot of stories like that out there, and those are good stories to have. You definitely want to get those opportunities when you go to a school. If you're walking on, you want an opportunity to play. You have to earn it. You work really hard to get those moments.
Well, Shane Davis is using his second green card tonight, challenging that tip from Coyle. He thinks that Lee kept it up. He's got a good point.
I think he's got a good point right there. A little pancake action. Lee's right hand.
Michelle Lee gets it back there. line play by Michelle Reed. Tell you what, the Northwestern bench has brought the energy all night, too. They are very loose here on the road in Tampa. Everyone getting involved. Or set toy. Bump set from Lee to Gerbach. Back set for Cannon, and she's blocked. So after the challenge, after the replay point, Iowa gets it anyway.
And they get this point because Cannon really tried to go line when that set was inside, but unfortunately for her, an Iowa blocker was right in front waiting.
Molly Kelly. Gerbach takes it at Kelly. Or to Hoy. Tip for the kill. 29 now for Kelly Hoy.
And we haven't seen a tip out of her in some time. There was a great changeup for Kelly Hoy. Northwestern back on their heels, not able to get it.
Kelly. Bomber sets Gerbach again, getting a lot of swings here early on in set five.
And Iowa's got somebody rotational defense with both defenders going out to the corner. The middle back is open. So Gerbach likes that shot.
Escuso has been terrific serving tonight. And it sets up another point for Northwestern. Escuso's got four aces. It's a career high, and she has caused Iowa issues tonight. She's behind the line once again. It's just falling off the table on the Hawkeyes. Free ball from Kelly. Bomber sets the middle to Walker. Dug by Kelly. Bump set from Viscuso, and Northwestern can't get the free ball over.
Late in this match, the ball control becomes really important, Mike. And this is where you need to tighten it up and making sure every contact is clean. On both sides of the net, I'm seeing just lack of ball control on both sides of the net.
Gerbach down the line. Kelly's bump set. We are level at four. This Saturday night on BTO, we've got two of the nation's best squaring off in Lincoln. Michaela Fecky and number 9 Nebraska off a win tonight in Columbus. They horsed Jordan Poulter and 6th-ranked Illinois. Big Ten Volleyball is powered by American Ethanol. Saturday, 8 Eastern, right here on BTN and the Fox Sports app. Swings out of system for Kelly Hoy, and a couple consecutive points for Northwestern.
Well, Lana Walker was there ready and waiting. Just be patient. And an out-of-system play as a blocker, you don't need to make any special moves. You just got to hold your ground and making sure that your hands go over the net nice and low.
Terracera Northwestern, 6-1 tonight.
It's all about the timing right now.
Here's Callie Horn. Bomber sets Gerbach. Point Northwestern.
It was a good bounce back by Sarah Johnson, missing that serve, but then getting a 3-point pass right there, platform out to her friend Brett Bomber for the kill for Gerbach.
Good balance tonight from Northwestern. Lisiak serves short. Or to the back row for Hoy. Now the overpass. Put away by Lewis.
Lewis being physical at the net. Hands up. Ready to go in any given moment. Finds a way for that fast point opportunity.
Hasn't been the biggest, gaudiest night for Taylor Lewis. That was a timely kill from her. 6-6 in set 5. Bomber on the back set. Alana Walker. Second on Northwestern. She has 15 kills, building on a career high.
Good first ball. Tied out opportunity. Allie Lindroth giving the ball to Britt Bomber. One-on-one opportunity. Really slides it past to Taylor Lewis. Really impressed with Alana Walker tonight.
She can touch 10, 5 and a half. She's got a high ceiling as well. Maybe combined. Robinson tools the block, and the Wildcats are up by 2. So we get a stoppage at the midway point of set 5. Northwestern head coach Shane Davis said to us, we want to get 15 to 10, 20 deaths for Alana Walker. How about 15 kills for her?
Oh, 15 kills. She only had 5 killed last time these two teams matched up against each other. Kick it is done from behind the setter on that right side pin. Really in rhythm.
Part of this balanced attack for Northwestern. Walker's got the career high. 4 different players in double figures, all with at least a dozen kills.
This really helps their effort right now. This is why they're in this success.
Bomber has really set the career high and then some tonight. She has 64 assists in this 5-set affair. 4. Seth Lewis. Nice dig by Lee. Or to the dot, Lee handles it. Robinson with coverage off the block. Back to Robinson, tip try. Dug by Iowa. Back row Hoy. Orr throws it deep to the corner. Bomber sets Robinson a third time. Off the block. Bomber back to Robinson for the kill. On her 4th swing of the rally.
I don't even know where to start with this one, Mike. I love the fact that Bree Orr is delivering every ball. Michelle Lee dig out. And then you've got Mia Robinson for the kill for a huge point.
I'll tell you where to start. Maybe a deep breath after that one for Mia Robinson. Getting her jump count up tonight. 22 kills for Robinson, who had 25 in the first meeting between these two.
I'm looking at Iowa side too. Taylor Lewis is up there. Being an offside blocker is really important. She wasn't getting much space between her and the net.
There is Taylor Lewis. Just long in Northwestern is up by 4. And thinking huge road win tonight. Timeout. Monshevsky wants to talk it over with the Wildcats on a 4-1 run. So instead, they will challenge here again. If you go to a 5th set, you get an extra challenge. Monshevsky had 1 remaining to begin with, so he does have 1 more after this one.
They didn't use many in the first couple sets, and boy, it really came out strong.
We were clear.
Both of them. And here we go. We're taking a good look here at Taylor Lewis, really stretching out with that hitting arm.
Lewis free ball. Robinson gets the kill. She's got another.
She's going to bust her way through that block every time. She's got the energy to do it in the fifth set, which is really important for an outside hitter.
And now Iowa does take the timeout with Northwestern's lead up to five in set five in Iowa City. Hey, on BTN, just like tonight, we've got a doubleheader of volleyball on the way. Minnesota tries to remain unbeaten in the Big Ten. They square off with the Spartans. Then it's Dana Retke leading Wisconsin against Carly Scott and the Wolverines in a high-powered ranked matchup. Big Ten volleyball always powered by American Ethanol Friday right here on BTN and the Fox Sports app. Second half of the Big Ten season. Come to you tonight from Carver Hawkeye Arena. Northwestern is trying to win its second Big Ten match of the season, trying to get another one within its last three matches. A 5-5 in set five. Bump set from Molly Kelly to the back row for Hoy. And it's a violation on Northwestern. Point to the Hawkeyes.
Ooh, they got a funny Hoy out there. She's the one that got him to this point.
Bomber sets Robinson. That has been the recipe for Northwestern.
Yeah, how about it? When they need it, she's there. And there's Mia Robinson getting that huge approach way behind the 10-foot line, going straight in knowing that she's going to tour.
24 for Robinson. Bomber goes back to her. Cross court kill. 13-7.
Boy, I'm watching Brett Bomber doing a nice job of leading the Mia Robinson out of system play. That was a huge ball because it wasn't the perfect pass.
Northwestern can smell it on the road here at Carver Hawkeye. 25 kills. For Nia Robinson, she has been excellent tonight. Northwestern is just 2 points away from a crucial 5-set win on the road here in Iowa City. Shane Davis has his parents here, Sherry Davis as well. They're loving it. They're in from Denver, Iowa.
Well, Iowa folks, and they're ready to obviously really enjoy this win in the next couple points. And look at Northwestern's bench finding the energy to make it happen.
BYOE, bring your own energy. Sometimes you need that late night on the road. Callie Hoy out of the back row. She has 3 kills again tonight. She has already matched a career high. Lewis, got the touch.
And that she's waiting for all night long. A little flatter and faster out to the pin where she can take that first step and deliver.
Allie Johnston comes back in to serve, the sophomore from Lakeville, Minnesota.
Perfect.
Robinson, 26 now. A new career high for the sophomore from Indy.
Yeah, getting it done on the right side pin. The setter going against the grain, even against a double block.
So before match point, we will have a challenge. Von Schmansky has used all 4, maximum you can have.
Looking to see whether the ball is in or out.
City. Trying to grab a win in 5. Robinson serves. On the overpass, net call, and Northwestern gets the point and the 5-set win on the road.
Well, the celebration begins right now for Northwestern in this next half of the Big Ten Conference. What a win for a program that has really struggled in the first half. Finding ways to win for Northwestern last couple of years has been difficult. And Iowa really, really helped.
The Davis clan can rejoice back in their home state. The Wildcats take down Iowa in 5 sets tonight. And it's the Wildcats over the Hawkeyes. That's it from Carver Hawkeye. The Wildcats victorious. Coming up next on BTN, it's Big Ten football and beyond. Tune in to BTN Friday night for a doubleheader starting at 6 p.m. Eastern. Gophers and Spartans will start off that doubleheader in action. For Liz Tortorello Nelson, producer Danny Blunt, our entire crew, Mike Monaco, say goodnight.